today I'm going to try to convince you that we can really harness the power of evolution to engineer insights for our desired applications. All the living systems are really the products of evolution. From everything from viruses to high organisms, we really have evolved. The evolution is really the process of diversification and selection. The best example of evolution that I could think of is actually the evolution of the neck of the giraffe. In bikini giraffe is giraffe has shorter neck, and because of the diversification process, the offspring of short neck giraffe have different neck length. They can have a shorter neck than the parents. They can have the same neck length. They can have longer neck length. And because of the selection process, taller giraffe is more accessible to the food source, which is the leaves of a tree. And so giraffe with longer neck length is more fit and can reproduce more offspring. So, and this process can be repeated, and the medium length giraffe, neck length giraffe, can have offspring that have the same neck length and different length of neck. And again, the longer neck length giraffe have a high access to food source. So that's why we have the giraffe that we, the length of the neck of giraffe that we've seen today. And at this point, sorry for reviewing the secret already. At this point, I kind of think to myself, this is really the best example of evolution. And so I did some Google, and I was wrong. This giraffe is not the best example of evolution. And the best example is in the next slide, which is this one. I'm really sorry if I offend Trump supporters here. Since this is not the kind of politics I would like to continue on the theme on evolution. So life is really, as you said, that is really a college, a living system that tries to sustain itself by using enzymes to convert chemical compounds to one to the other compound. And this picture shows the metabolism of living systems. And each dot shown here is a chemical compound found in living systems. And the lines that connect these dots are the chemical transformation process that that catalyze or that accelerate the reaction from one dot one compound to the other. So the chemical reaction cannot actually the chemical reaction can occur spontaneously, but at the physiological conditions like the pH, neutral pH, and at the room temperature, these reactions is spontaneous reaction occur too slowly. And I'll show you how slow these reactions are. Let's have a look at the first reaction, which is porosimetric rearrangement, and that takes, the spontaneous reaction takes 7 hours to finish. To go from the 100% to 50%. And there are some reactions that related to the carbohydrate metabolism and the protein metabolism that can take like 2 days and 7 years. And some reactions that related to nucleic acid metabolism can take up to 80 million years. That means like if we don't include something that can accelerate these reactions, life that we know cannot exist. And enzymes are biological macromolecules that can accelerate these reactions. Like they can accelerate from 1 million-fold rate enhancement to 10 to the 17 rate enhancement. So this is a remarkable molecule. And we can really harness the power of evolution to really create things that we don't have in nature. And it's the same way that the nature does. We can really use the evolution to engineer enzymes or this the catalyst to fit the need, to fit our needs. And it's the same process as natural evolution. The process of direct evolution consists of two steps, which is a diversification and selection. But like the diversification process in nature is so slow. When we make copies of DNA and RNA in nature, we have like a proof breeding step, and that prevent the copies of our genetic materials to have errors. But in our laboratory, we have tools to really make copies of genetic materials that have a few mutations, and these allow us to generate like the variants of enzymes faster. And the next step is selection. This is the step that is, I think, the most important in a directed evolution process, because like we get what we select for. If you set up an experiment that selects for higher enzyme activity, you get enzymes with higher activity. But if you like select for put the enzymes in a higher temperature, the variants that can survive under these high temperature conditions can survive and can be selected. So like this is the most important step. And the way to do the selection is like this. If you have remember that I talk about the metabolism of living systems. Now we have a compound A converted to compound B, and this reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme. And if the compound B is an essential compound, meaning that life cannot exist without compound B, we can use this knowledge to do the selection by, let's say that if we knock out, we delete this enzyme from the organism, then the organism cannot grow, right? Because the organism needs the compound B to survive. But if we make a variant of the enzyme, and this variant is worse than the parent enzyme, then you have less compound B, and then the growth of the organism would be less than the original the parent organism. But if the variant is better, can produce some higher compound B, then this variant would allow the organism to grow faster. So this kind of I concept can really be used to engineer enzymes. And this is a general concept. What I'm doing in my lab right now is I'm trying to make a perfect enzyme. And perfect enzyme is, according to a famous biochemist, Jeremy Knowles, he defined a perfect enzyme is as an enzyme that every time enzyme works by like colliding with its substrate. And most enzymes in nature, when it collides with the substrate, it releases the substrate. Perfect enzymes is every single time that the enzyme collides with the substrate, it catalyzes reaction and then releases the substrate and convert the substrate into the product every single time. And this my goal is to make a perfect enzyme, and I am very interested in what you like after hearing my talk, like what kind of idea you have, what kind of enzymes or what kind of evolutionary experiments that you would pursue in order to like get something like new. And with that, I'd like to thank the organizers and the host for inviting.